Hi there, Doug Stuman with IT Creations with a Dell rack server, the Dell PowerEdge R650 Server. This is a one-use system that packs plenty of performance and options. It features dual third-generation Intel Xeon Scalable processors, and at maximum capacity, it can deploy up to 8 terabytes of DDR4 memory. There's also room for up to 3 GPUs, plus a few different storage options depending on your workload. Dell has already released their R660 server, so this may be a little late to the party. That said, we don't have to deal with those pesky upgrades to the base model, which usually makes these videos somewhat dated before their time. There is definitely a difference between Dell and many other server manufacturers. Dell has a base model that can be configured to support a number of different options, like storage, network communications, risers for different PCI combinations, PSUs, and even GPUs. And surprisingly, it still has the same name. Other manufacturers will change the name and the SKU to reflect even the smallest change, like support for a 750-watt PSU instead of a 650-watt PSU. Respect to Dell. I do like the simplicity, not to mention only 4 characters in the model, and yet it can still be found by Google search. However, with that simplicity comes a bit of complexity in the number of options available. Starting on the front of the chassis with the storage, first, there is the optional bezel, one with an LCD screen and one without. Both have a lock for security. Underneath is where you have a choice of either 10 or 8 SAS, SATA, or NVMe 2.5-inch drive bays. Those configurations also support 2-4 universal bays, so you can have NVMe in those bays with SAS or SATA drives supported in the other bays. Alternatively, you can go all in on SAS, SATA, or NVMe. Since the third-gen Intel SPs support PCI 4.0, the NVMe drives supported are U.2. There's also an option for 2 2.5-inch drive bays in the rear of the chassis, but we will get to that in a moment. Also available is a configuration with 4 3.5-inch SAS SATA drives, but no NVMe. If you want to install SAS drives, then you will need an HD controller, or in Dell parlance, a PERC, or PowerEdge RAID controller. You will have to decide on these options before you purchase. Neither the 10-bay, 8-bay, 3.5-inch, or 4-bay 3.5-inch chassis configurations support an internal optical drive in that media bay area. Are you interested in the Dell PowerEdge R650 server? I mean, who wouldn't be? A short and concise naming convention? Dual third-generation Intel Xeon Scalable CPUs? Up to 8 terabytes of memory and flexible hybrid storage options? I mean, not to mention networking and other options. If your answer is yes, then click that link to see more information. And when you're ready to make a purchase, just mention this video to save up to $500 off the purchase price of a system listed on our site, or one that you can configure that's priced at $5,000 or more. Need more than one? We offer volume discounts. ITCreations.com. All of the configurations have a small control panel in the left server ear. It features a system health LED, system ID, status LED, and the iDRAC Quick Sync 2 indicator, but only on certain models. That Quick Sync indicator allows you to connect to the server using an iOS or Android-based smartphone or tablet, leveraging iDRAC 2 through the OpenManage mobile app. Quick Sync is only available on certain configurations, but from what Dell is providing, seems like it's available on the 8-bay and 10-bay configurations, as well as the 4-bay 3.5-inch chassis. System health and system status seem kind of similar, but you do get more information with that status LED, which enables you to identify failed hardware components. On the right side of the chassis, you'll find the on-off button, USB port, iDRAC Direct micro port if you decide to forego the Bluetooth-enabled Quick Sync 2, a VGA port is in various locations depending on the storage. Oh, and more LED status lights on the actual drive trays for at-a-glance status. Moving around to the back of the chassis, we have more options, and let's just start with those PSUs. Power consumption has a direct correlation to how this system is outfitted. So there are options for 800-watt, 1100-watt, 1400-watt, all AC, and an 1100-watt DC option. That little panel right next to the PSU on the left is for optional hot swap M.2 BOS or boot optimized storage subsystem. With that little unit, you can install 2 M.2 drives in a hardware RAID to boot the system. Much better than those M.2 drives that are mounted on the system board, because hot swap and accessible. But again, it's another option, and you will pay a bit extra for that. Across the bottom of the chassis, we've configured this system with 2 gigabit Ethernet ports. Beside that is a slot for an OCP 3.0 card that can slide right into that slot from the back of the chassis to provide additional network connection options. It'll support a number of different ports and bandwidth connection speeds, and again, hot swap. Beside that, an I/O panel with a system ID button, VGA connector, 2 USB 3.0 ports, and an MLAN port to manage the system remotely. For remote management of the system, Dell has their proprietary integrated Dell Remote Access Controller, or iDRAC, and in this case, iDRAC 9. iDRAC enables administrators to access the system from anywhere using a standard browser interface. You can also access iDRAC at chassis using the OpenManage mobile app we discussed when talking about the front left control panel options. And then there's the OpenManage system management portfolio, assuming you don't go with some other third-party management utility. OpenManage has several software utilities to make managing, updating, and allocating resources much easier. It also has several plugins to integrate with other utilities like VMware vCenter, Red Hat Ansible, Microsoft System Center, and Nagios Core, to name almost all of them. Again, if you want to install SAS drives or just want more RAID options with SATA drives, you will need a perk. Again, we have options for types of perks and locations where they can be installed. Some are for internal drive support and some are for external, like a host bus adapter or HBA. In addition to the drive bays up front, there is a dedicated mounting position for the front mounting front perk. That one goes in that media bay area above bays 6 through 7 on the 8-bay chassis. There is also another position, which is the rear mounting front perk module. And that one attaches on the top of the storage backplane for the 10-bay system that has no media bay area. Of course, you can always use one of the PCI slots to install a perk, which are available in a multitude of form factors. The CPU provides 8 memory channels for 16 channels total in a 2-processor configuration. With 32 memory module slots, this system can support 2 DIMMs per channel, and when installing Intel Persistent Memory Module Series 200, or PMEM for short, there are 2 distinct modes. Memory mode adds more memory. App mode will activate the persistence of the memory modules for data resilience in the event of a power failure. These are options you will choose in BIOS. PMEM, in this instance, can be mixed with registered DIMMs, load-reduced DIMMs, or 3DS versions, but you can only install 1 PMEM module per channel. In other words, 16 total across 32 memory module slots. There are plenty of guidelines for installation. This system can take up to 8 terabytes of memory, either 3DS RDIMM or LRDIMMs, or up to 8 terabytes of PMEM. With PMEM at maximum capacity, you can install 16 512 gigabyte modules for up to 8 terabytes and add RDIMMs or LRDIMMs or those 3DS versions in the remaining slots for a total of up to 12 terabytes of memory. Standard RDIMMs and LRDIMMs will provide significantly less capacity at up to 2 terabytes of memory. Third generation Intel Xeon Scalable processors can support up to 40 physical cores and 80 virtual threads using Intel's hyper-threading technology. With the latest fourth generation Sapphire Rapids, they've bumped the core count to 60, but let's stick with our current platform that supports third generation CPUs. With 2 CPUs, that's up to 80 physical cores, but only using platinum modules, as the gold tops out at 32 cores and silver at only 20 cores, with various price levels in place top to bottom. If you need all those cores, then go platinum. If not, gold or silver, as CPUs are quite expensive. Again, 8 memory channel architecture and support for Intel Persistent Memory 200 series modules, which is something AMD does not have yet. Third gen Intel SPs support DDR4 memory and PCI 4.0, 64 lanes each for 128 lanes in a dual processor configuration, which leads me to the PCI slots. There are more options for risers, and depending on which risers you choose, you can have x8 slots, x16 slots, or a combination of x8 and x16 slots. The expansion slots will extend the capabilities of your system. You can choose from high-speed network interface communications, up to 200 gigabits per second, HD controllers, because you simply need more RAID options, or SAS support, or how about up to 3 single-wide 75-watt GPUs, FPGAs, or acceleration cards. At that wattage, power is provided by the slot, and you're basically looking at the tried-and-true NVIDIA T4 Tensor Core GPUs with a 75-watt power draw. Good for a wide range of options, or perhaps one of those NVIDIA A2 cards featuring Ampere architecture. Also good for a range of applications. So what have we discovered? I think it's that if you want a server with a simple naming convention, a lot of options, that's well assembled and not without an upsell factor, then go Dell. I mean, in many ways, maybe there should be a different name for some of the storage configurations, but then where do you stop? To recap on the Dell PowerEdge R650 server, it's got dual third generation Intel Xeon Scalable CPUs, up to 8 terabytes DDR4 memory, or up to 12 terabytes using Intel PMEM, sprinkled with some RDIMMs or LRDIMMs, and several storage configurations, including 2.5 inch 8 bay, 10 bay SAS SATA or NVMe, and 3.5 inch 4 bay SAS SATA configurations in a little 1U chassis. You can have your cake and eat it too. If you want one of these little gems, check out itcreations.com. We have plenty of options for you, and if you need a little bit more storage and support for more powerful GPUs, there's always the Dell R750. Until next time, I'm Doug Stuman with IT Creations, and thanks for watching.